Folks, this is a true hero. Let's welcome Bill Connor. Y'all were on the river back in February at the first tea party in the history of South Carolina.
Yeah.
Isn't this amazing? I mean, this is absolutely amazing. I think back, those 15 months ago, just before I announced my candidacy, they had this tea party. And I was short time back from Afghanistan. I really had never been politically involved in this way. And so many citizens, you know, expected 20 people. They came, 3,000 came out. 3,000 came out to hear on that day. And, you know, initially it was ignore the Tea Party movement, ignore it. And finally, they couldn't ignore it. So they started making fun of it and making up stories about it. But I'll tell you what, come Tuesday, they're going to see the power of the Tea Party movement. And you know how you're making an effect? It's when you start getting attacked. Okay, as Nikki's found out.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to tell you the attack that came on me today. It's so funny, I've got to talk about it. I was with an establishment candidate at a television interview. And y'all know my story. I volunteered for Afghanistan, was downrange. You know, no questions asked about combat. This guy had the nerve to ask, make a statement. Bill Connor says he was in combat, but there are other things to report otherwise. And the establishment will do that. And they'll throw, now in this case, of course, I can prove it wrong because my evaluations are recorded, the records are out there, eyewitnesses. But you say other things to people, and it's a he said, she said. Isn't that wrong? Yeah. Doesn't that stop in South Carolina? What's amazing is they don't get it. The establishment does not get it. The South Carolinians are sick and tired of this. You know, the day after some allegations came out, I went to a coffee house that was around a bunch of, you know, regular people. And they all said the same thing. We're sick and tired of the mudslinging, and we're supporting Nikki. And I gotta tell you, it was amazing. Amazing to watch.
Yeah!
And I'm sick of it too. I gotta tell y'all something though, as a political outsider, someone who never run before, and in my case, I told you a story. I was actually born in Hawaii because my dad was going back and forth to Vietnam, and I've got my birth certificate. You know, I grew up that way, went to the Citadel, went in the military, and Ranger coming to command, Light Infantry coming to command. What I learned, though, was leadership from the best place possible. In this case, was outside politics. What you learn in business, what I learned in the military at the Citadel, you learn that it's mission first, people always.
Right.
You learn leaders eat last. You learn things like duty, honor, country are not just words. It's a way of life. And, you know, you look around the career politicians, they don't get it. They don't understand that. Because for them, it's leaders eat first, and leaders take care of themselves first. That needs to end, and they need to be thrown out, and we need reformers in office who aren't career politicians. And I told you, my own personal story was 8 years ago, I was brought to a saving faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. I don't care what our president says, we are a Christian nation. And that doesn't mean we're shoving the Bible down people's throats. That means our founders understood that freedom works. That it's about small government. That charity is the job of the church. It's the job of the family. It's the job of individuals. But you know, they've completely lost sight of what our founders intended in every way, shape, or form, both socially as well as fiscally. And we need reformers to come back in and set things straight. You know, my own story, I talked about why I'm running. Again, I was sort of somewhat away from the political scene. I'm a Christian first, conservative next, then a Republican. But I went to Afghanistan, and what I saw was absolutely amazing. Because I saw the strength of our nation and our young people we sent out. And I was a senior advisor in Helmand Province. I just sent out little spots in the out throughout the province. They were with the Europeans, though. So I had the chance to contrast Europeans with American fighting men and women. And the contrast was stark. And what I saw was that Europe, which has gone socialist, creates a different person. It's someone who's lost their freedom, who looks to government for everything. So we were out there on the battlefield. Our guys used hard work, initiative, ingenuity to get the job done. We lost some good people, but they fought for us hard because that's what America's all about. The Europeans many times sat on their hands and wouldn't do a thing. I come back home and realize everything I'd raised my right hand to defend 20 years ago was slipping away. Our Constitution was slipping away. Because here's the deal. Government is not the answer. Freedom is the answer, and I firmly believe that. Can you hear a hand, please? So, like many of you who really hadn't been politically involved, who many of you, again, were probably Christians first, conservatives next, and then Republicans, realized something's wrong and decided to get involved. Because here's the bottom line. The Republican Party needs to quit pointing fingers and point fingers back, because the last 8 to 10 years, they have really let the American people down, and we need to rebuild trust in the American people. Let's give that a hand, please. There are individual Republicans. I view Senator Jim DeMint as one good example who stood true to principles. Yeah, thank you. Let's hear from Senator Jim DeMint. I gotta tell you, what's amazing though is the number of career politicians in the Republican Party who are just as bad as the Democrats, who grew government just as much, who didn't understand it's not only about cutting taxes, it's cutting spending, and grew the government, lost the faith of the American people. What we need now is we need outside faces that people can believe in to come into office, reform things, and turn things upside down. That's what we're gonna do come Tuesday. I'm going to do as Lieutenant Governor. I'll tell you one thing God will do, is I promise you now, I will work as a team with the next governor, whoever that is, because we need that. We need to quit all this headbutting, very well could be. we need to quit the headbutting, and we need to work as a team to get things done, and we need to use reform. I'm going to tell you something right now, it's going to take two reformers at the top, because we're going to be fighting a battle. Look, I faced Taliban bullets, I won't back down to the Senate. Whoever's elected governor can depend on me to work as a team to fight back and make sure that we move forward and move South Carolina forward. You know, I'm so excited about our future early on. The energy has been incredible. But here's the thing. I know in my case, I'm going to be outspent by 10 times. When I first started my race, and Nikki was in the same boat as this, they said it was a joke. There's no way they can win. They can't raise the money. It's a marginal campaign. It's going to go away in January. Aren't they shocked now? Aren't they shocked? Because I know in my case, like, wait a second, you told this guy, wait a second, it's not supposed to happen. Well, it's happened because they forgot something. It isn't all about money. It's about the people. It's about the fact that we come to serve you and not the other way around. So here's what I ask you. Here's what I ask you is please do all you can to get folks out to vote. Because we can talk and talk and talk. Right now, though, the question mark is the Tea Party only talk or is it action? And again, I'm going to be outspent. I know Nikki's going to be outspent by an incredible amount. The establishment's out there. They're going to take every anti-establishment candidate, push them to the side. We're going to have to fight back. We're going to do it not by money, by word of mouth, by getting out the vote, and make sure people understand that every single vote matters. It truly does this election. And I want to make sure that it's not just a win. In some ways, it's a slaughter. But we come in here, and they understand the Tea Party means something. Yeah. Let's make sure we do that. Before I end, I just want to say one thing, and that is thank you from the bottom of my heart. Because for my campaign, again, I started it 15 months ago on the banks of that river speaking, and it made me make the final decision to announce my candidacy 5 days later. And I've spoken to almost every Tea Party I possibly could, and this has been the base of who I am. Now, I was taking a risk initially, because a lot of career politicians said, oh, don't get involved in that, I said, no, look, this is a movement that means something. I've stood by you as far as making the Tea Party. You guys have stood by me. Stand by me on Tuesday. Stand by me between now and then. Please get the word out. And let's get in there. Let's kick some butt and take Columbia back. Thank you.